Look, look, kids. Just a minute. I'm going to tell you a true story about Easter. And you have to be real still so you can hear all the truths. Okay?
Yeah.
I'll read it to you. About this book, and it's beautiful. It's all about Easter.
Okay.
It was a long, dark night, and Jesus was in trouble. Some people said that he was the king of the Jews. King Herod didn't like it. While Jesus prayed, Peter, James, and John sat under a tree keeping watch. But one by one, they fell asleep. Before sunrise, Jesus saw another disciple coming. It was Judas, with a crowd carrying torches and swords. Jesus woke the disciples. "Hello, Master," said Judas, and he kissed Jesus on the cheek. Now the priest knew which man was Jesus. Jesus was arrested. Peter swung his sword, but Jesus told him not to fight. Peter, James, and John, they ran away. Jesus was taken to the chief priest. Peter had followed and was listening to them from a safe distance. But someone spotted him. You were with Jesus," they said. "No, I wasn't," said Peter. "I don't know him." Three times Peter said he didn't know Jesus, just as Jesus had said he would deny him. Cock-a-doodle-doo, and that was the third crow. Then the rooster crowed, and Peter cried because he hadn't stood up for Jesus. The priest took Jesus to Pilate, the Roman governor. "Are you the king of the Jews?" Pilate asked him. Jesus said nothing. Pilate asked the crowd, "What has he done? He's hurt no one." But the crowd was angry. "Who shall I let go then?" asked Pilate. "Barabbas, Barabbas, the murderer, or Jesus, the king of the Jews?" "Let Barabbas go," they cried. Pilate was amazed, but he let Barabbas go. The crowd made fun of Jesus as he was taken up the hill called Calvary. They put a crown of thorns on his head, and Jesus was nailed to a wooden cross between two thieves. "If you're the Son of God," said the mean thief, "why don't you save us? Save yourself." At midday, the sky went dark, and the darkness lasted for 3 hours. God forgave them. Jesus cried. They don't know what they're doing. At the same moment, the earth trembled with an earthquake, and Jesus died. A Roman soldier was standing guard. The earth trembled, and Jesus died. A Roman soldier was standing guard. "He really was the Son of God," he said. That evening, a man called Joseph took Jesus' body to a stone tomb. He was washed. He washed Jesus and dressed him in clean clothes. Then he rolled a heavy stone over the opening of the tomb. The soldiers came to guard the tomb. See? All this time, Jesus' friend, Mary Magdalene, and Mary from Galilee were watching. 2 days later, Mary Magdalene and Mary from Galilee came back to the tomb. The soldiers were gone. The stone was rolled back, and the tomb was empty. shining. Angel said, "Don't be afraid. Jesus is alive." They ran quickly to tell the disciples. But on the way, they met Jesus. "Don't be afraid," said Jesus. "I will meet the disciples in Galilee." The disciples went to Galilee and waited. While they were talking, Jesus suddenly appeared. They were frightened. "Why are you afraid?" asked Jesus. "It's me." He showed them the marks on his hands and on his feet from the cross. "Go tell the world what God has taught us. If we do bad things, we should be sorry. If other people do bad things, we should forgive them." Jesus led the disciples to a place called near Bethany. He lifted up his hands and blessed them, and Jesus left them and was taken up into heaven. The disciples went out into the world. They spread God's message just as Jesus had told them. Now, who led the crowd to Jesus is the question. How many times did Peter say that he didn't know Jesus? How many times?
Three.
How many?
Three.
Three times. What did the crowd put on Jesus' head? How did Jesus die?
On a cross.
Where was Jesus buried?
In a tomb.
Who found out first that Jesus was alive?
Me.
Two women. Mary Magdalene and Mary from Galilee. What does the story tell us? The true meaning of Easter, that Jesus was the promised Messiah who died for the sins of the world, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. That is John 3:16. And that's the true story of Easter. Yeah.